Hi everyone, hope you are all healthy and safe. Today we will be discussing about Treacher-Collins syndrome. Do you remember the Treacher-Collins affected Augie in the movie Wonder? Now let's quickly go through this rare syndrome. Treacher-Collins syndrome is also known as mandibulofacial dysostosis. If you could remember the synonym itself, you will be able to recall all the clinical features. This is a rare genetic disorder with deformities of ear, eyes, cheekbones and chin. Usually it is autosomal dominant, but it can also occur de novo. The genes involved are TCOF1, POLR1C, POLR1D. Among this, TCOF1 is the most common. So the mutation of TCOF1 results in reduced amount of triacyl protein, which in turn results in reduced number of cranial neural crest cells migrating to the first and second pharyngeal arches. So the first and second pharyngeal arch structures are mostly affected, which obviously is the reason for abnormal facial features. As mentioned already, it is a rare genetic disorder, incidence ranging from 1 in 10,000 to 1 in 50,000. The syndrome is named after Dr. Edward Treacher-Collins, who is a British ophthalmologist. Now let's look at the pathologic and clinical features. So some patients are mildly affected while some are severely affected. And the anomalies are often bilaterally symmetrical. Most important feature is the craniofacial abnormality. Let's see what are the abnormalities in ear. There could be absent external auditory canal, preauricular tacts, pits, fistula, dysplastic ears. There could be deafness, and which is usually conductive hearing loss. Another feature is choanal atresia or stenosis. Now let's look at the picture. So in the ears, there could be absent external auditory canal, auricular tacts, pits, fistula, dysplastic ears, deafness. Let's see what are the characteristic features in the eyes. There could be downward slanting of palpebral fissure, coloboma of eyelid, partial or complete absence of eyelashes in the lower lid, and hypertelorism. Other features are macrostomia, microstomia, flat malar region, hypoplasia of mandible or zygoma, high arched palate and cleft palate. Now let's look at the picture. There could be flat malar region, macrostomia, microstomia, cleft palate. In the mandible region, there could be hypoplasia of mandible, which causes retrognathia or micrognathia. The gastrointestinal and cardiovascular system may also be affected in this syndrome. In GIT, there could be anal atresia or stenosis and tracheoesophageal fistula. And cardiac defects are also seen. Coming to diagnosis, prenatal ultrasonogram is a useful tool in diagnosis, which may show polyhydramnios, microcephaly, abnormal facial features like micrognathia, hypoplastic zygoma, abnormal orbits with ocular fissures slanting downwards, cleft palate. There could be abnormal fetal swallowing as well. In a suspected fetus, genetic testing may be done for TCOF1 mutation, which is diagnostic. Auditory evaluation has to be done in a suspected newborn. If the baby has breathing problem, a laryngoscopy may be done. CT temporal bone may be taken to look for development of ossicles and also to rule out other causes of congenital hearing loss. An MRI may be helpful to evaluate internal auditory canal. Now let's look at the management. When a child is born with this syndrome, the primary concern is securing the airway. Management of airway and feeding is the most important for infants. So basically, a multidisciplinary approach is needed in management depending on the age. For airway problem, mandibular distraction and tracheostomy may be needed. The cleft palate repair has to be done at 9 to 12 months of age. If there is hearing loss, it is treated initially with hearing aids, that is bone-anchored conduction hearing aids. Often, reconstruction of cheek and maxilla are needed, which includes eyelid correction, zygoma and orbital reconstruction, and is done at 5 to 7 years age. For external ear reconstruction, the child has to be at least 8 years old. Orthognathic surgeries are done at 13 to 18 years age, and nose reconstruction if... Thank you for watching. Please do mention your doubts and your suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you.